children, and including those we may come into contact with later on after leaving here. A reminder also to put your presents in the friendship pad. Add your name and contact information if we don't already have it in our office. Later on in the service, where the bulletin says rooted in love, Danny Miller will be our speaker today. We apologize that we did not get his name into the bulletin beside that. And you will notice that when we begin worship, the call to worship is a little bit different. We're using the psalm. We begin by singing the refrain. So Ruth will play through that refrain once, and then we'll sing it. Then there's responsive reading, and then it's sung again and a second time. And that is how that works. You can stay after church today and go out into the back parking lot for a trunk or treat, because today is Halloween. It is also the day closest to All Saints Day. And so we will be celebrating Totenfest when we remember and honor those that were lost during the last year. I think that's all the announcements. No, what else?
Well, actually, I have Asperger's syndrome. Ordinarily, I go to a different church. Why I'm here today is a long story, but because I have Asperger's syndrome, I've got a hard time getting a job, partly because I can't wear a mask for very long, and I'm because I have asthma. So I'll need prayers for the best job available and a small amount of money.
All right. Welcome to worship this morning. God is not in some remote heaven, but here in our worship space. We are summoned by our holy God, who calls us each by name and gathers us in the unity of Jesus Christ. Let us prepare for worship.
Thank you. joined together and the liturgy this morning, and Ruth's going to play that first refrain for us.
Stand if you are comfortably able.
Thank you.
to church, do you? No, what is today, Spencer?
Friday.
It's Friday? It's trick-or-treating today, also known as Halloween, right? But we start celebrating Halloween because at one point it was called All Hallows Eve. And the reason it was called All Hallows Eve is because it was the day before All Saints, yes, and before Christmas, absolutely. Absolutely, you're totally right, Spencer. But it was right before All Saints Day, which is tomorrow. And so I wanted to gather around this table this morning because I wanted to show you these candles. And in a little bit, we will celebrate those who have been hallowed or made holy this year, right? When we say hallowed, that's kind of it's a big word, and a lot of grown-ups can't even really wrap their minds around it. But it means that we are celebrating people who have become holy in this past year. And so when we were doing that, way back, like in the very early part of the church, we would dress up in costume to ward off the evil spirits because we just wanted to recognize those who had been hallowed. So Halloween celebrates the saints of the church. Right? Does that make sense? That's an awful lot. Yes. All right. Let's say a quick prayer, and then you guys can go back to your seats, okay, and wait for trunk or treat. Will you pray with me? I'll start, and then you guys can echo, okay? Dear God.
Dear God.
Dear God.
Thank you for loving us so much.
Thank you for loving us so much.
And thank you for the saints that we're celebrating today.
Thank you for the saints that are celebrating today.
Amen.
Amen.
Thank you, guys. I'll see you guys in a little bit for trunk or treat, okay?
I'm open.
Yes.
Thank you.
us hear the good news now as it comes to us from the book of Revelation, the 21st chapter. Then I saw a new heaven and a new earth. For the first heaven and the first earth had passed away, and the sea was no more. And I saw the holy city, the new Jerusalem, coming down out of heaven from God, prepared as a bride adorned for her husband. And I heard a loud voice from the throne saying, "See, the home of God is among mortals. He will dwell with them. They will be his peoples, and God himself will be with them. He will wipe away every tear from their eyes. Death will be no more. Mourning and crying and pain will be no more, for the first things have passed away." And the one who was seated on the throne said, "See, I am making all things new." Also he said, "Write this, for these words are trustworthy and true." Then he said to me, "It is done. I am the Alpha and the Omega, the beginning and the end." This is the word of God for the people of God.
Thanks be to God.
Hey, I have a kind of a riddle for you. See if you can get the answer to what I am describing here. Our entire life depends upon it. People fear it and work to avoid it. Presidents are elected by promising it. Bookstores are crammed with guides on how to create it personally and manage it professionally. Sometimes it's the only constant in life, and other times people desperately want it but can't seem to muster it.
Change.
I heard it, say it again.
Change.
It is change, yes. The longer we live, the more of it we see. This isn't the same world we lived in as children. Some of the changes are hard to adjust to, hard to live with. Others we recognize right away as a great thing. Most people remember their childhood as being idyllic and wish things hadn't changed at all. Then again, who really wants to go back to summers without air conditioning? Or do you really want to go back to having to count the minutes on that long distance call to Aunt Joanne and then cut it off when the price goes too high and you cannot afford to talk any longer? Another changing classic is the Bible. In the ancient world of Judaism, scripture was memorized and passed on orally. Then the Hebrews took papyrus technology from the Egyptians and wrote on scrolls, and later on a sturdier parchment made from dried animal skins. Finally, in the 15th century, the printing press revolutionized the world by getting Bibles into the hands of non-clergy for the first time. Today, people bring their Bibles to church with them on their phone. Change happens, whether we like it or not. It actually is a necessary part of life. There is a book called Canoeing the Mountains, written by pastor and author Todd Bolsinger. In it, the author talks about the church today and this world that we live in, and compares it to the journey of Lewis and Clark. You know, Lewis and Clark made a journey to try to find the waterway to the Pacific Ocean. They started on the water, rowing upstream all the way. Finally, they made it to the mouth of the Missouri River, and they were sure that if they just carried their canoes, a mile or two over some minor mountains, then they'd be able to put their canoes into the Columbia River and coast easily on down to the Pacific Ocean. Based on what they had seen have to discard their canoes, throw away the oars, and cross the Rocky Mountains. Now, the church had great successes in the 50s and 60s, even into the 70s. Churches tended to fill up, and the first thing people did if they came to a new community was to find a church and go there. But we don't live in that same world now, and we can't just do what we did before and expect the church to thrive and grow. We cannot base our future travels on what we have seen in the past. We've been rowing our canoes, and we might think if we just row harder, work harder, we can get back to the church the way it was 50 years ago, or even just back to where it was 2 years ago, pre-pandemic, as if everything was perfect then. But we're going to have to give up the canoes and find a new way for the church to travel, because whether we like it or not, change is the air we breathe. This is a period of change, especially for this church. Pastor Susan left, and things are now different. I do things differently, as will every pastor that comes in here. And you all have changed, too. Life and death and birth and growing up, moving into town, people moving away from town, these changes are a part of life and a part of the life of every congregation. Despite that life situation we find ourselves in personally and as a church, today's text from Revelation offers some hope. It shows us what does not change. The book of Revelation is a great book about the love of God and the love of Jesus Christ. And that is what doesn't change. God is the one who is and who was and who is to come. Like Alpha and Omega, A and Z in the Greek alphabet, God is before and with and after all else. Though the times are uncertain, John in the book of Revelation is sounding a classic message. God made a covenant with the people long ago, saying, I will be your God, and you will be my people. And that doesn't change, past, present, and future. In your chaotic life, in the life of an ever-changing church, God serves as the anchor point. Changes will come, but God will be with us, because God's love is steadfast from generation to generation. Amen. Our hymn is The Church's One Foundation. We will stand if you are able.
Amen.
sovereign presence in our lives. We thank you for your steadfast love and faithfulness, for your mercy, which is new, and your grace, which is sufficient for each day. We thank you for your constant presence, your redeeming love, and the gift of your peace. God, we acknowledge that our world is in great need of your presence and your grace just now. Violence, hunger, and disease impact more and more people every day. COVID continues to rage through the world, and people continue to be hospitalized and to die from the disease. Children are abused, workers are exploited, and the planet is being thoughtlessly destroyed. Our relationships are fragile, and we no longer know who or what to trust. God, be with us and lead us to deeper love and trust of you. God, today we pray for people around the world, as we pray for those that we know and love. We pray for Shirley, Larry, AJ, Lydia, John, and others we know who are not named here, but are held close in our hearts and in your heart, O God. As part of your church in the world, we pray for the people in Egypt, and with them we pray for unity, that the people may hold one another close like kin. May we all be co-workers in your mission, graciously giving and accepting help where there is opportunity. Speak to us, O God, we pray. Speak a word of peace to our fears, a word of comfort to our suffering, a word of faith to our doubting hearts. Draw us near and shelter us within your mighty and strong arms. We pray in the name of Jesus Christ, who taught us to pray these words. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our debts as we forgive our debtors. Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Sermon this morning for this Bible verse, so I don't really have to do the hard part to convince you that, you know, sometimes change or not being stagnant is the answer, right? And so here we go. It's Hebrews 10, and I'm going to start at verse 23. Let us hold fast to the confession of our hope without wavering, for he who has promised is faithful, and let us consider how to provoke one another to love and good deeds, not neglecting to meet together, as it is the habit of some, but encouraging one another, and all the more as you see the days approaching. And what really stuck out to me on this part is the verse that says to stir up and provoke one another of love and good deeds. My family, the reason why we love this church is because there are so many people here that stir each other up to love and good deeds. Many of those, will be celebrating their life today, listed in the bulletin for Tobinfest and over the past few years. But as the stewardship committee makes plans to be intentional about how this church will continue to stir up love and good deeds in this community and our wider community all over the earth, in those various wider missions, it really helps them out to fill out the card so that they know how much that to plan on giving and throughout the year to budget. And I want to encourage everybody to not just financially be involved, but more like to use the gifts and talents that God has given you, no matter how big or small, to stir up love and good deeds. Like, those are action words that are done by people, not necessarily by money, okay? So, like, that's really where my heart has been, is in, like, Pastor Lisa said, the making sure that change is not something that we're trying to avoid. Thank you.
Let's celebrate and dedicate to God our giving and our sharing. Will you stand if you are able as we sing the doxology? Throughout Christian history, the church has continued to remember and celebrate the lives of faithful people who have died. It is a way of remaining related to deceased loved ones, as the process of grieving and remembering is vital to our health. It's a time to remember and celebrate the lives of those who were known and loved, who have passed. last year. And it is a way of celebrating All Saints Day, realizing our dependence and our thankfulness for all the saints of the church. We pray to be gathered again someday with those who have gone before, and to remain in communion with all the saints of the church. Hear their names again as we remember. Larry Miller, brother of Rosemary Spray, born to life eternal, February 15th, 2020. Stephanie Stakeman, daughter of Rich Stakeman, born to life eternal, September 23rd, 2020. Calvin Dierberg, member of St. John's, born to life eternal, October 29th, 2020. Raymond Sontag, member of St. John's and father of Larry, born to life eternal, November 16th, 2020. Richard Spray, brother-in-law of Rose Marie, born to life eternal, December 3rd, 2020. Donald Castellan, member of St. John's, born to life eternal, December 22nd, 2020. Dolores Scholl, member of St. John's, born to life eternal, January 17th, 2021. Wilma Storts, mother of Helen, born to life eternal, February 1st, 2021. George Miller, brother of Rosemarie, born to life eternal, April 12th, 2021. George Tindira, member of St. John's, husband to Carol, born to life eternal, May 9th, 2021. Loretta Thompson, member at St. John's, born to life eternal, July 21st, 2021. Harry Weber, brother-in-law of Evelyn, born to life eternal, August 20th, 2021. Audrey Schwartman, friend of Kathy and Mike, born to life eternal, September 2021. Bob Swanson, friend to Mike and Kathy, born to life eternal, September 2021. And we pause now also to remember all of those that we've lost, those that may be unnamed here, perhaps those that were lost longer ago than in the last year, but are still close to us in our hearts. And I invite you to join in the responsive litany of remembrance. Blessed are the dead who from now on die in Christ.
They will rest from their labors, for their deeds follow them.
We do not want you to be uninformed about those who have died,
so that you may not grieve as others who have no hope.
For since we believe that Jesus died and rose again, even so, through Jesus, God will bring with him those who have died. But someone will ask, how are the dead raised? With what kind of body do they come?
When you sow, you do not sow the body that is to be, but a mere seed.
But God gives must put on imperishability, and this mortal body puts on immortality. For we know that if the earthly tent we live in is destroyed, we have a building from God, a house not made with hands, eternal in the heavens. Jesus said, "In my Father's house there are many dwelling places. I go to prepare a place for you. I will not leave you orphaned. I am coming to you." The Advocate, the Holy Spirit, will teach you everything and remind you of all that I said to you.
Jesus said, "Peace I leave with you, and my peace I give to you. Do not let your hearts be troubled, and do not let them be afraid.
I am the resurrection and the life. Those who believe in me, even though they die, will live. And everyone who lives and believes in me will never die. For God created us for incorruption and made us in the image of God's own eternity.
The souls of the righteous are in the hand of God, and no torment will ever touch them.
They are at peace, and their hope is full of immortality.
Because God tested them and found them worthy. Amen."
Will you stand if you are able for the singing, the remembering for all the saints? Let that safe place
know how to do that.
Let me shut this off.